Fiddler on the Roof. Sounds crazy, no? But in our little village of Anatevka, you might say, every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? We stay because Anatevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word. Tradition. 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 Because of our traditions, we've kept our balance for many years. Here in Anatevka, we have our traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to work, even how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered, and we wear these little prayer shawls. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you, I don't know, but it's a tradition. Because of our traditions, everyone here knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
Whole day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers. And who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The Papa! She's pretty. The sun, the sun's tradition. The sun, the sun's tradition.
And who does Mama teach to mend and tend and fix? Preparing me to marry whoever Papa picks.
The daughters, the daughters,
five daughters.
Tradition, the daughters, the daughters. Tradition. Day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers. And he has the right, as pastor of the house, to have the final word at home. She's a papa.
In the circle of our little village, we've always had our many special types. For instance, Yenta the matchmaker.
Avram, I have a perfect match for your son, a wonderful girl.
Who is it?
Rachel, the shoemaker's daughter.
Rachel? She can hardly see. She's almost blind.
Tell the truth, Avram. Is your son so much to look at? The way she sees and the way he looks, it's a perfect match.
And Reb Nochem, the beggar.
Alms for the poor. Alms for the poor.
Here, Reb Nochem, here's one kopeck.
One kopeck? Last week you gave me two kopecks.
I had a bad week.
So, if you had a bad week, why should I suffer?
And most important, our beloved rabbi.
Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing for the Tsar?
A blessing for the Tsar, of course. May God bless and keep the Tsar far away from us.
Among ourselves, we've always gotten along perfectly well. Of course, there was a time he sold him a horse, but delivered a mule. But that's all settled. Now we live in simple peace and harmony.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule, I tell you.
It was a horse. She was a mule.
Tradition, tradition. Without our traditions, our life would be as shaky as a fiddler.